Everyone, welcome to round one. We have lost the roll, unfortunately, and so we're probably gonna be on a draw. This hand, it's a little slow, but we don't really have too much ramp in this deck compared to what I normally like to play. But we do have Consecrated Sphinx and Thran Dynamo, so I think I can risk keeping this. We'll choose to keep. Hopefully, we're not playing into mono red or anything like that. Otherwise, ooh, look, it's mono red, maybe. Endrick. That guy's pretty good. Blocking, that is. Okay. Now I'm not as worried. Red-green is a lot slower. Ooh, and we have a grizzly bear. So, assuming we actually draw some lands, and if we manage to connect with Fauna Shaman next turn, that'll be sweet. Wow, what is this? Alright, so this is fine. This morph, not really sure what it is. Let's check it out. So I think we can probably force a trade here. Hopefully this isn't Gathen Raiders. Nope, it's a Histrodon. And if we spike a land, we can play Thran Dynamo and Fellwar Stone, and that'll be pretty sweet. If not, then we'll just play Fellwar Stone and attack if we can. So this guy's playing the 3.5 color special. And let's see what he does. He's probably going to port us during our upkeep, but we have a play with Fellwar Stone, and if he lets us draw a card with Edric, then yeah, looks like not. So I guess we'll have to just play Fellwar Stone. It's probably going to port our forest, but we have a Savage Lands in hand. Do we have a land? Nope. We have an Indric Stomp Howler, which is going to be a mulligan unless he plays an artifact or enchantment. But I think this is good enough to play main deck, just because there tend to be a lot of artifacts and enchantments to blow up. So we'll just have to wait and see. He's probably going to tap out for something now, and if we can land this Harmonize, then that should draw us into a few mana sources. And it looks like he's just going to go in ahead and do nothing, except port us again. Probably this time the island, since it's our Fellwar Stone gives us two green, so he's probably going to want to reduce this to only two blue sources. Yep, and there's... I really hope to draw land. Oh, okay, excellent. So now we can go ahead and... him porting us is going to be a lot less productive for him. So he's probably going to cast something, then we can land Consecrated Sphinx and draw a bunch of cards. Let's see if we have a fourth color to worry about. Hopefully it's just Jund. I can deal with Jund. And we got a lot of card advantage here. So, oh, maybe an Armageddon? There was an Armageddon in the draft. There was a lot of stuff. I mean, this guy can play literally anything. And we have a Broodmate Dragon. Oh, sure, all right. So we're actually playing against Jund. Tidings, that's a card. So we can play Tidings, or we can play Tidings on Wheels. And let's see, what kind of removal would we be playing against? Kind of want to play Tidings on Wheels just because he, let's see, got 4, 8. So this would be 10. So unfortunately, it doesn't really work. We could go 1, 2, 5, make a guy, and be a few short still. So let's just go with the Consecrated Sphinx. And draw some cards. Hopefully this guy can block. I'll pretty much block, since we've got, I mean, both Harmonize and Tidings in our hand. We have a lot of oomph to keep us in the game. So I'm not really too worried about losing Consecrated Sphinx. And there's Mortify. Well, that kind of sucks. So he's probably going to bash us for 11 now off of Treetop Village. Yeah. Won't be able to port us, but... so we're probably going to have to play Maloku and upheaval a bunch of lands. This is going to suck for us. Unless we draw opposition in the next few turns, I think we're probably going to be in a little bit of trouble. Green Sun Zenith. That gets Avenger. That doesn't really do much for us, though. So I think we're going to go ahead and play Moloku. And then ship the turn. Don't want to harmonize now, because got to make some dudes to block. Probably just going to upheaval ourselves. And, oh, well, we'll see what he does. Kind of scared that he has a bunch of removal in his hand. Alright, so what we're going to do is, I think, make three guys, block one on the dragon. Yeah, make four guys and block the brute, or the, let's see, what maybe, the dragon token. Keep Moloku around for a little bit. We end up going to five from that. Should suck a little bit. Hestrodon, Terminate, and Mortify. Yeah. Unfortunately, this guy's deck is all over the place, but looks like he's just green, black, white, splashing Broodmate Dragon and Terminate. So, whatever. So let's hope he doesn't have anything. One, two, three, four. Let's see. Do we have any bounce? No, I don't think we have bounce, so it doesn't really matter. So actually, I think we're gonna go ahead and block the real one. Actually, no. Scratch that. So, there was much more reanimation than anything else, so I'm going to go ahead and play around a reanimation spell. And since Consecrated Sphinx would be a little bit easier to deal with, and Parallax, something like Parallax Wave is only one card. So I think that's okay. Yep, and it looks like it has something. It's a Lightning Helix. Okay, well, that's unfortunate. Probably board this Indrik Stompholler out. So unless we draw opposition, we're going to be in a little bit of trouble. And that is assuming he actually lets us get that blue mana. He's probably just going to port us. And do I want to make a guy? Well, we can Green Sun Zenith or a bird, then upheaval ourselves. So I'm just going to go ahead and wait to see what we draw. Through land. Okay. So we'll go ahead and play another island. And Zenith for one. Yeah, it looks like we're going to be definitely on the ropes this game. Probably bring in Stunted Growth against this guy. Maybe restock. It's unfortunate they had the Mortify. I would have liked to be able to unlock those guys. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and make a guy chump chump. I think at this point our only out is to draw opposition. So, assuming he ports us, I'm going to go ahead and actually just block with... I'm just going to make one guy, and then block a token. Go to one, and then hope to draw opposition. Putrid Leech. Yes, of course. Why would you not have Putrid Leech in your Lightning Helix deck? Recurring Nightmare. Ah, that's a cute little combo. So at least we know we can probably keep this in. And so he's going to port us. So does that really matter? Do I need to keep the mana around? I think I do. So I'm going to go ahead and... So if we draw opposition, then we can go island, play opposition, have two floating. Actually, it doesn't matter. So we'll just go ahead and let him do that. And nope, so... Looks like we're almost dead. So I'm going to go ahead and play... the Stomp Howler. Kill his recurring nightmare. Then now we can... Let's see. He's got four guys, so if he activates his treetop village, then we're dead. Hopefully he doesn't see it. Oh wait, no. Looks like he is. Yeah, I actually should have floated. As it turns out, yeah, that would have been better. Would have stayed alive. Okie dokie. On to the next game. So... let's take a look at what we can bring in. Well, I think we can probably just take it. Maybe take out Mold Shambler for negate. We can also could you imagine desertion on his Broodmate Dragon? That'd be something. I like most of this. I mean, just the Broodmate Dragon was. What really gave him the edge there, just because he wasn't, without it he would have had very little pressure on us. So I think I'm going to just board in the negate and then take out the Stomp Howler, because we already have, or we can take up the Mold Shambler. I mean, that would mean that if he has any Planeswalkers, then we can't destroy him, but that also means that Zenith for Stomp Howler is an option, whereas Zenith for Mold Shambler is just making a 5 mana 3/3. And those are only so good. So, I think that'll be that. So let's go ahead and take out the Mold Shambler. Well, the Mold Shambler does blow up lands, and he does have quite a an ambitious mana base. Still, I think that's okay.